Welcome to the Know Before You Go Travel Show, where we share all the latest travel tips, tricks, and insights to make your next vacation the best one yet. So sit back, relax, grab a cocktail, and enjoy the show with Penyak Travel's George Penyak and our senior travel consultant, Janet Penyak.
What is up, everybody?
Hey, everyone.
Welcome back to another edition of the Know Before You Go Travel Show, when we've got a show for you today. And we are back on a hump day. It is Wednesday. We are halfway through the week. For those that don't know what hump day is, remember the camel commercial?
Hump day. Yeah, I think it's a common term.
Yeah, hump day.
Yeah, you're like getting over the week. Leading into the weekend.
I love Thursday's one of my favorite days of the week.
Yeah, because it's Friday Eve.
It kind of feels like the weekend's here. And to celebrate, we're having ourselves a little wine.
Yeah, wine down Wednesday.
Probably just one glass. Just enough to kind of, you know, you can ease into bed.
Maybe two. We'll see.
I don't know. We like to have a glass of wine on hump day. Yeah. But anyways, it's hump day. We hope you guys are having a great week and you're getting through the week. And it, at least in our neck of the woods, it is finally warming up.
Yes, it is.
Oh my gosh. We have had the coldest, wettest winter that I can remember for our standards. It was just cold
and wet. A lot of people would laugh from other parts of the country would laugh at that.
I know. We're so pathetic. And I really feel bad for Texas. I mean, that was awful what they went through. It almost felt like a once in a 100-year thing, which we have a lot of friends in Texas, and it's a lot of them said it happens once every 10 years or so there.
Yeah.
But just awful. The power was shut down, and then all the pipes now are breaking. It's just, they're not built for that. Like, we're not built for that here in South
Carolina. No, we're not built for that kind of weather.
But our hearts go out to all of those that were affected. I mean, that was just awful, and the pictures were just unbelievable.
Yes.
Like, seeing Dallas like that, just covered in snow.
Frozen, yeah.
I mean, it's surreal, and it's incredible. But I hope everyone's okay.
I'm sure that had everybody dreaming of somewhere warm to go.
I know. And we're seeing so much news, and we've been saying it, that people are dying to get out. And there is so much news and articles and research coming out. And people I talk to, they're just like, I need to have a vacation on the books.
Yeah.
Got to have it. Like, they just, it's the itch.
Yes.
The itch is becoming unbearable.
And I have the itch again, and I feel like, you know, I might just bypass my initial thoughts on traveling I think I just want to go.
We're going to end up going somewhere. I mean, you know, I can't stand being in the same place for too long.
Whenever the new testing requirement in order to come home came out, I was very, did not want to do that. Did not want to risk that.
But now, it's fine. Yeah.
Now I'm feeling like, you know, a little more risky.
It's not risky. It's just, I'm just comfortable with
yeah,
it.
Yeah, no, like, it's not risky.
It's a comfort level. Like, I'm comfortable
with it. I would just,
with it.
Like, you know, I mean, where we're booked for April, we have to test anyway. So I was going to say, I just test before you go and then be careful. And
you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to tell the nurse to come down on the beach. I'm going to have my margarita in hand, and then I'll just, you know, be sitting in my pool chair. And
it doesn't work like that.
Really?
No.
I know. We went. We know how it works. We went and saw it all go down. Okay, we're good.
Yeah.
But anyways, it's very, so this episode, though, we're going to talk a little romance.
Yes.
Because it's February. February went by fast. It's like the shortest month ever.
Right.
But it is the shortest month ever. But anyways, Valentine's Day, you know, it's a intimate month.
Yes. And a lot of, you know, weddings and honeymoons from 2020 got pushed to this year, you know, because of COVID. And so that is what we are primarily booking right now, is a lot of romance vacations, anniversaries, just couples getaways, honeymoons.
Destination weddings are real popular right now.
Yeah. So we wanted to kind of compile a list of what our most popular ones that have been booked for 2021.
Yes. So this is going to be the most romantic destinations, and we're going to sprinkle in some resorts.
Yes.
And probably a couple things to do while you're there. So if you're planning a honeymoon or an anniversary or something like that, you should get some great information in this. We're going to share our best tips and our best kind of places that we like to go when we're looking for an intimate getaway.
Yes.
And I think we get a lot of good client feedback from a lot of these resorts. But first, before we do, I got to give ourselves a little shameless plug here. By the way, guys, if you want any more information on anything you're about to hear, please feel free to hit us up. We are a free service. If you want a quote or anything like that, just go to penyaktravel.com, request a quote. The link is in the show notes as well. And you can also slide into our DMs on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, wherever you can find us. We're out there at Penyak Travel, and we love you guys. And also, before we get to the show, we have a lot of love to spread because we've had so many listeners reach out and request a quote or want want more information on a trip. And literally, that is like one of the best ways to support the show. And so we really appreciate it. So we got a couple shout-outs here to give. John in Houston, Book Secrets, Plymouth Harris. We've been there recently.
Yes.
I love the sushi place, by the way, at that restaurant or at that resort.
Yep.
Jamie in Michigan, Book Sandals South Coast. That's also very high on our list, on an all-time favorite. Kevin in Salt Lake City, looking at Cancun. Thank you so much, Kevin. Suzanne in New York, looking for a Sandals anniversary trip. I'm going to pronounce this name wrong, but I think it's Techie. In Charlotte, looking for a honeymoon. Local Charlotte, feeling the love.
Yes.
And then Nathan in Detroit, looking for Secrets Cap Cana, which, in my opinion, is one of the best values out there, is Secrets Cap Cana. Oh, and then also, too, we had Bishoy Azar reach out. He is from New York, I believe.
Yes.
And he is looking for a trip to a couple different places, right?
Yep, Cancun first.
Yeah.
Yes. So thank you guys for reaching out. We appreciate it so much.
Yes, thank you guys. No, seriously, thank you all. Thank all of you guys for reaching out to us. You get Janet's expertise for free. Mine certainly for free, but hers is the better expertise.
I was going to say it's better.
It's way better.
I was going to say that.
I'm Sideshow Bob. I'm along for the ride. But anyways, let's get into the show. So we've got a lot of good stuff to cover here. Where do you want to start? Because we're talking, when you think romantic, and I think this is, let me ask you this. This is like a common mistake, or not a mistake, but like a common thing I think couples do is they look at all these different destinations and resorts, and they don't know that probably adults only is probably the best way to get the most intimate experience, romantic experience. I think for most adults, you might not want to go to a resort where there's a lot of kids and a water park and things like that. That's not really romantic and intimate. What do you think?
Yeah, no, I would definitely agree with that. Now, a few of these are not adults only on our list, but they are pretty popular for anniversaries and honeymoons. So they are on the list. And these are ones that have been the most booked for us for 2021 so far.
Yeah, and I think, you know, as we were like putting this list together, we've been to nearly all of them, and so they all feel really at home to us, and we're very familiar with all of them. And also, too, I think there's things you can do, special things you can do while you're on property to enhance kind of the intimacy and romanticness of, did I just make that word up?
Romanticness. Yeah.
Romanticness.
Never heard of that.
It might
be
a word.
Is that the wine talking?
No, I've had like two sips. It can't be. Enhance the romance. Enhance the romance.
Enhance the romance. There you
go. Of your trip.
Yeah. I mean, you can do things, you know, like couples massages, special dinners, candlelight dinners on the beach.
Candlelight dinners on the beach are special.
And those are so nice. I definitely recommend doing that for sure. So,
where do you want to start?
Yeah, I was going to say, to kind of get us kicked off, should we start with the absolute most booked one destination or lead up to that?
Let's work our way up to that.
Okay.
I mean, they're all pretty heavily booked, but
yes. We'll
work our way up to the top.
Okay. And our top booking destination will probably surprise you guys, but that's okay.
So yeah.
It's good.
And we're not really starting from the bottom, but there is one clear cut that's at the top. So I think the other ones are kind of, you know, we're not ranking these from, you know, 7 to 1.
Right.
Right.
Yeah. Right. So let's look at Hawaii first.
I think that's a good one.
Yes.
And it's, listen, we're opening back up. It's
yes.
A U.S. destination. A lot of people, I think, are going to stay in the U.S. maybe this year. And I don't know. I think a lot of people are going to leave there too.
Yes. A lot of people are leaving too. But the U.S. is definitely, Hawaii, it's always a hot destination, but especially this year because you are within the state. So you have to test in order to go, but you do not have to test in order to come back. And Oahu and Maui are pretty much open. So one of my favorite resorts in Oahu, and I have stayed here and it's beautiful, is Turtle Bay. So it's on the north shore of Oahu. Very, very different than like when you're in downtown Honolulu and Waikiki, which has a lot going on, a lot of hustle and bustle. Turtle Bay is just very peaceful and quiet and serene. And I absolutely love that resort. And they've got a lot of great accommodations as far as like beachfront villas, or if you want to do like just a regular hotel room, it's beautiful. And they're actually undergoing a full renovation on that resort right now. Now, it's not all inclusive. You can't find that in Hawaii, but the resort is being fully renovated right now. And prices in August are starting at $461 per night.
That's not bad at all. Now, you have to factor in your food and drinks.
Right.
And, you know, it's not cheap in Hawaii. It's going to be more expensive than probably in your local hometown, your food and beverage. So again, just something to be mindful of.
Yes, definitely. And I have several honeymooners that were supposed to go last year, and we have moved their honeymoon like 5 times now. So hopefully they'll actually get to go this year. But yeah, they're very much looking forward to Turtle Bay.
And I think a lot of people are in that boat. We've had a lot of clients like that that have moved weddings, have moved honeymoons.
Oh, yes.
I mean,
on more than one occasion, yes.
And moved just vacations in general. But these big events, they're it's not tough to move, but it's like, oh gosh, really, I got to move this?
Yes, yeah. So. Now, another great option, and that we see a lot of honeymoon couples book, is the Sandals Emerald Bay in Exuma. And if you don't want to fly across the world and get it to get, you know, water like what you would get in Bora Bora,
yeah,
you can get very, very close to that in Exuma, Bahamas. They have the most beautiful white sand beach, crystal clear blue water. When you land on the island, it's basically a two-room airport. It's very, very small. You feel like it's so different than, you know, when you go to Nassau. So you feel like you're a world away from everything. It's very quiet, laid back, low key. Love, love, love that resort and love that island.
Yeah, and a lot of people judge the Bahamas based on Nassau because they went on a cruise and they, you know.
Right.
This is totally different.
It's totally different.
You feel like you're very remote. You feel very isolated. And you're right. The water is so blue. It's unbelievable.
Yes.
Like, you don't need a filter. So you can go on the Instagram and go wild. Hashtag no filter on this stuff. Because
yes,
it is that pretty. And there's unique experiences there. Now, this might be as romantic as some of the other experiences I mentioned. But you can swim with the pigs.
Yes, you can swim with the pigs.
And you can make that romantic.
Yeah, it can be romantic. When I did it, I got pooped on by one. But yeah.
I mean, it is very romantic.
But yeah, I mean, it can certainly be romantic.
Yeah, and just bring an extra towel.
I mean, you got the ocean right there, so it just rinse off.
But the videos look so much fun. I mean, I haven't done that. You have. I'm very jealous.
Well, that's where we are booked for April, so.
Yeah, that's going to be my birthday trip. And they have awesome golf. So
they
do. If you have two golfers that are in love, you have two golfer lovebirds, you're not a golfer, but I am, go golf.
Yeah, I will sit in the cart.
I mean, and if you have to see pictures of this, too. If you're considering golfing, just Google it and Google image it, and you'll see these beautiful holes right on the water, right on the blue water. Incredible experience.
Yes. Now, prices for Sandals Emerald Bay, and all of these we just pulled for August, so it's starting at $859 a night. So, and that is all inclusive, so all your meals, drinks, non-motorized water sports, everything is included with that.
And with how nice the beach is there, I would recommend, now, if you're going to do a candlelight dinner on the beach, that is going to be extra.
Yes.
And I think it starts at, what is it? Is it $125 or $250 or something like that, right?
You're off, but
how much is it?
$199.
Oh, I was close, but
yeah,
I was right on both
sides.
How'd
you go from $125 to $250? It's a big difference.
Because I thought it was $199.
Oh, all right, yeah, that makes total
That's
sense.
Right. I was all over it. But anyways, it is totally worth it. And one tip that I would have, and this is for the guys out there, bringing your ladies. Surprise them. Set that up through your butler. Set that up somehow. Don't tell them you're doing it.
Or, yeah, we can pre-book that for you, too.
So. We can pre-book it for you, too, and make it a surprise. And then you have, like, a very intimate romantic candlelight dinner on the beach with a private server. No one's around. It's unbelievable.
Yes.
We've done it a handful of times when we travel.
Yes, and I absolutely recommend it, for sure.
Yeah.
Now, moving on further down south in the Caribbean, Antigua, which we actually visited Antigua in August, and it was fabulous.
It was amazing, yep.
Yes, so two great all-inclusive resorts there that I recommend, and I see them booked very often for honeymoons and anniversaries because they're very, people that are looking for something very small, boutique feel, very relaxed and quiet. I often find them booking these. So Coco Bay Resort in Antigua.
Yep.
And that is starting at $394 per night. And then also Galley Bay in Antigua, which Galley Bay, if you have been a longtime Bachelor watcher, then you might recognize it. They filmed one of the Bachelor trips there in 2013. So Galley Bay, Antigua, and both of those are adults only and all-inclusive. Galley Bay starting at $751 per night.
Yeah, and that's perfect. And, you know, again, Antigua is one of those destinations because when we looked at this list, it's like, what destinations are romantic? And I think Antigua has that romantic vibe to it.
Yes.
It's pretty exotic.
It's unique, yes.
It's unique, and the beaches there are unbelievable, too. So if you're a beach lover, Antigua is a great option for you, something to definitely research and look into.
Oh, yeah. 365 beaches, one for every day of the year. That is their slogan.
That is their slogan. And, yes. You know, the Sandals isn't bad, too. I don't think the Sandals is a bad option.
No, I absolutely love that resort. I don't want to keep repeating, you know, like Sandals and yeah. everyone, which we do, obviously, book a lot of those and definitely recommend it. But for those looking for, like, a more, like, quiet, like relaxed getaway, yeah. then I would suggest the other two.
Yeah, and I think wherever you go, Sandals is worth looking into, especially for an anniversary or honeymoon, because it's not only adults only, but it's couples only.
Yes, big difference.
Every restaurant has two tops.
Yes.
You're not going to find these big groups. There's going to be no bachelorette or bachelor parties there.
Right.
It's literally going to be couples only, so it makes it kind of extra romantic. So I think it's just like an honorable mention worth noting for Antigua.
Yes. Now,
and go visit the little floating tiki bar out there, too.
Yeah, especially if you are staying at Sandals, please go see Contiki. It's no frills, nothing, you know, fancy about it.
It's not romantic, but it's awesome.
It's not romantic, but it's really fun if you want to make for a fun afternoon. Just, you know, make sure you don't get, you're not offended easily. Because yeah. those the owners of that, they're funny. They're very, very nice, but they just sit there and just drink all day and get drunk. And
they have no filter.
They have no filter.
But it was a ton of fun. And again, like something like that, that is such a memorable experience.
Yeah, I'll always remember that.
If you're going to honeymoon in Antigua, just go check that place out. Like Google it, Contiki Bar. I think they actually still call it Bar and Grill, but it's just a...
Yeah, I don't know what their grill
there's
is.
There's no grill.
It's there's
just,
no grill.
It's literally just a floating tiki bar.
Yeah. No bathrooms. The ocean is your bathroom.
Yeah, so. I don't even think... I think the ice they bring every day in a cooler, they don't even have like electricity out there.
No, they don't have electricity.
Everything's battery powered.
Yeah. Yeah, and then they close at sunset because...
You can't see.
Yeah. So a very interesting place. Now, moving along to the other side of the world. Now, currently, French Polynesia is closed right now, but hopefully they will reopen. I think the current plan is April 1st. But Bora Bora, I mean, hello, you can't get...
You have to factor in Bora Bora.
Yeah, you can't get much more romantic than that.
I mean, you're in your own overwater bungalow. It
yes.
doesn't get more romantic than that.
No, and I mean... I pretty much would recommend all of the resorts there. I don't think that you can go wrong with any of them. You know, the Conrad is amazing. The Intercontinental, I would just suggest the Intercontinental Thalasso instead of the Le Moana, because if you're at the Thalasso, it's on one of its own private motus and facing like the main island where you can see Mount Otamanu. So I would definitely do that one first over the other. And then the St. Regis, the Four Seasons. I mean, you can't go wrong with any of them. Le Méridien, I stayed there as well. They're undergoing renovations, so they're closed, I think, for the whole year. But the St. Regis is amazing. I've sent a lot of honeymoon couples there. And currently they have in August, Beachside Villa, $1,618 per night. And then Overwater Bungalows, $1,804 per night. And these come with breakfast. And then a Mount Otamanu view, overwater bungalow, and you have a jacuzzi out there that overlooks that as well.
Oh,
and that's
man.
Starting at $2,980 per night.
Oh,
so, I mean,
gosh.
It is definitely, you know, it's very high end. It's one of those destinations that is very high end. But I will say you will get lower pricing now than you would, you know, say in 2019. So
yeah, and it's going to price out a lot higher than what you're going to see in the Caribbean or even Hawaii. I mean, you're getting a whole overwater bungalow to yourself.
Yeah,
and it's a very remote island, so everything's shipped in. It's going to be more expensive. It's going to be on the higher end for sure. But what you get back is it's not even a trip or vacation. It's an experience that you're not going to get anywhere else.
Yeah, it's a once in a lifetime. Maybe twice in a lifetime, but it's definitely, you know, it's one of those like bucket list experiences for sure.
Yeah.
And definitely keep an eye out because a lot of the resorts in St. Regis specifically, I've seen them do this a lot over the last year. They've run specials where if you stay like 5 or 6 nights, then they'll also include dinner for you too, which is a huge saving. So
that's a huge deal.
Yeah, so keep an eye out for those specials. They've been running them a lot lately.
Or book with a great travel agent like Janet, and she'll be watching them for
you. There we go. Now, moving back over to this side of the world, I've been getting a lot of requests for Turks and Caicos.
You know, I've noticed that. Turks is becoming more and more popular. And again, Turks, you know, when we went to Turks, it reminded me of the water of Exuma. Like, it literally, like, that water.
Exuma, I think, is a little prettier, but Turks is amazing.
Turks is up there.
It's amazing.
The beach is amazing. Yes. And it's the type of beach. So, like, when we went, we snuba dived.
Yeah.
We're not scuba, snuba, which if you're uneasy about scuba diving, snuba is awesome. And you can just do it right off the beach. You just walk right out.
Yes, in many locations in Turks and Caicos, you can. Now, one thing that you want to keep in mind with Turks and Caicos is there's not a whole lot of options for all-inclusive resorts. They're actually very few and far between there. There's, of course, the Beaches Resort, you know, which is the family brand of Sandals. Personally, I would not recommend that for a honeymoon just because, I mean, there's a lot of kids.
It is very kid heavy. I mean, Big Bird's walking around, Elmo, all of them. I mean, it's not, it's more family oriented than it is couples oriented. There is an adult side to it. There are like adult lounges and adult, you know, but
restaurants. Yes, there are. But
it doesn't feel that way though.
Yeah, I just think it definitely changes the vibe. And you know, you could of course go and, you know, times like February, March, or whatever, when kids are in school, but you're still going to have like the really small children there. So I just think it changes the vibe. So personally, I don't recommend that for a honeymoon.
I'd agree with that for sure.
Yeah. So a couple that you can look at, or one that you can look at, is called the Beach House Turks and Caicos. It's a pretty small resort, boutique style. It is all inclusive and it's right there on Grace Bay Beach. Beautiful resort and definitely laid back, you know, relaxed type atmosphere. And that one's starting at $735 per night.
Yeah, I mean, and that's a great option for Turks too. And Turks is, again, another small island, exotic, remote. We took a puddle jumper there, literally a puddle jumper
from Nassau.
From Nassau. That was quite the experience too.
On Bahamas Air, yeah.
Yeah, it was a prop plane.
It was fine, but it was just one of those.
Bahamas Air is not anything like what you would get in the States.
Well, yeah, it's kind of like, Air Tahiti, like the little puddle jumpers. They're a little bit bigger, but, you know, propeller planes, yeah, you know, that go between all the islands in Tahiti. But I personally am not a good flyer. And so
surprisingly, too, like, yeah, you would think you would be. Well, actually, no, I fly all the time. So maybe I'm definitely.
Well, I mean,
a
I have
flyer.
Flown a lot. I mean, yeah, I have flown hundreds of times. I can't even tell you, but I'm just not a good flyer. I've gotten worse as the years go by. And yes, that Air Bahamas flight, I immediately regretted getting on that plane. It was fine.
It was fine. It was actually surprisingly smooth.
It was like, very smooth. Know. It was just the propeller plane, and those just make me very nervous.
Yeah, as long as it's like an older pilot. Like pilots, I do judge by age. I want my pilot to be like a gritty old,
yeah, but
like war veteran that could literally, if the plane got shot down, he would land that sucker, or she would land that sucker anywhere, and we would all live.
Well, you never know though, because they could be like, well, I know this plane back and forth, and like ignore, you know, warning signals.
No,
I don't know. I guess you when you think about like Sully, who landed the plane
exactly, like I want a gray hair. A little bit of, you know, a little, and Sully's not like rough around the edges, but I want a little just like grittiness and the confidence. I like confident pilots. I want confidence.
Well, yeah, I definitely don't want them to not be confident.
I don't want, obviously, we don't want nervous pilots, but.
No.
But I'm always listening out like for the voice that comes on. I'm like, okay, do they sound confident? I mean, how are we feeling? How are we doing here? And yeah. I'm a fine flyer. I'm kind of exaggerating some of this actually while I drink wine.
I am not a fine flyer, and the slightest bit of turbulence sends my heart into my stomach. So.
Yeah, I know. I hold your hand now when we take off and it's sweaty.
Yeah.
And that used to be me. And then now I was forced to fly. Like I'm like numb to it now. I kind of cheer on turbulence.
Hey, you know, there are some people that literally need medication in order to fly. I'm not there yet. I'm not saying I might not get there one day, but
every time I'm in an airport, no matter what time, it could be 7:30.
Oh yeah, there's always
6:30 in the morning. Someone's having a beer or, you know, something to take the edge off for it. Because the bars are open.
Yeah, I don't blame them.
In major airports, the bars are open 24/7, 365.
Yeah, I don't blame them. Take the edge off.
Yeah, I mean.
Yeah, so moving on.
Yeah, we're
not on a little tangent. Gosh, yeah. So moving on, St. Lucia. St. Lucia is definitely a very romantic destination. I would highly recommend it. There are a lot of great options for different resorts and different types of experiences that you may be looking for in where you stay. And we honeymooned in St. Lucia, and we've been back for our anniversary.
Yeah, I would say about St. Lucia, St. Lucia is the most unique island in the Caribbean. I'm going to label it that because the Pitons, it's volcanic, it's very lush. You get a different feel there than you do anywhere else.
It's known as the Hawaii of the Caribbean, and I definitely think that it lives up to that.
Certainly.
You know, it is a volcanic island, so you're not going to have, you know, like the most amazing beaches like in Turks and Caicos, Antigua, Exuma, but you still have, you know, beautiful beaches, white sand, pretty blue water. It really is an amazing destination. Very lush, very green, very mountainous. I absolutely love it. You know, a couple of unique experiences there that you could add onto your trip is take a helicopter.
Absolutely. We've done that a couple times now, and it's like that experience, and they only put, like, if you book the helicopter ride, and you're talking about the helicopter transfer from
helicopter
the airport
to
the other side of the island, because if you don't take that helicopter transfer, most of these resorts are hour and a half away.
Hour to an hour and a half away, yes.
Or it's like a 7-minute helicopter flight.
Ten.
And we've got, if you go on our YouTube page, we actually have a video of us doing it, and you can see what it's like. But the helicopter literally, because it's kind of a mountainous island.
You know, mountainous.
Just like Hawaii is. So the helicopter literally takes you from the airport after you land, the plane lands, you get right on the helicopter, it literally goes right over the center of the island and drops you down.
Yes, and so there's the main international airport at the very southern end of the island, and then there is a smaller airstrip in Castries, which is kind of like on the northwest side of the island, and it drops you there. And then a lot of the resorts, for example, like the three Sandals resorts, are all about 15 to 30 minutes, depending on which one you go to from there.
And they'll come pick you up too from that area.
Yes, and the helicopter is it's $350 for a couple each way.
Yeah, and I just strongly recommend doing that because you're saving time and it's also a unique experience.
Yes.
Like it is really, really cool to do that, and it gives you a different perspective of St. Lucia because you can almost see 360 the whole island. It's not a huge island.
No, it's not. And one quick thing too, and I've said this on previous podcasts, but if you haven't listened to those, then you would know this. But if you are looking to book the helicopter, book it direct with St. Lucia Helicopters because it's a lot less expensive. For example, like I said, $350 for a couple. Whereas if you are, let's just say, going to one of the Sandals resorts and you book that directly with Sandals, they're going to charge you $470.
Yeah,
so it's a big saving. So just book it direct with St. Lucia Helicopters.
Yeah, and it's the same operator.
Yeah, it is the same operator.
Go before you go travel tip. Is a big one right there. And again, I think it's also a romantic experience because they only have, I think, 6 max that they'll take.
Yeah, there's 6 seats max.
So it's, and when we were in there, it was just us and one other couple, right?
It was six.
Was there 6? We were in the front and then they were in the back.
Yeah, it was 6 and then plus the pilot, so 7 people total.
It was so cool though. It was such a cool experience. And then you're literally walking on like the helicopter runway and the helicopter comes and lands.
I know, it's pretty cool.
And you're just like, there's my ride, like it's here.
Yeah, it's pretty like, cool. A couple of great romantic resorts, Sandals Grand St. Lucian, and they have the overwater bungalows there.
Yes, an option if you don't want to go to Bora Bora and get a similar experience. And they're beautiful. They're nice.
Yes, they are very nice, and I would definitely recommend them. One thing to note is these book so far out in advance, like especially for a week. I mean, if you're traveling within the next year, it is very hard to find availability for a week. So they did have, we found 3 nights available, and those were starting at $2,665 per night. Or if you do one of the lead-in rooms there, $676 per night. But I love this resort. You have exchange privileges with the other 2 Sandals. Currently, they're suspended because of COVID, but hopefully they will eventually bring those back. But I think that this one has the better beach of the 3 that are there.
Absolutely. And the difference, if you're comparing just overwater bungalows, we need to do like our own show on overwater bungalows. But
we have.
Yeah, no, but like comparing the two here. Well, yeah, I guess we have done one.
Yeah.
But that rate on the overwater bungalow for Sandals is all inclusive with your drinks, which is a big difference from Bora Bora.
Yes.
And if you're in the United States.
And that includes the butler service and everything. That St. Regis Bora Bora butler. That doesn't come with butler service too, but.
And you get the butler. Yeah, that's right. And like the flight time is so much shorter than going all the way to Bora Bora. Now, Bora Bora is way more exotic. You know, it's, I mean, actually St. Lucia I would call exotic.
I would definitely think it's one of the more exotic. Yeah, like you said, exotic destinations in the Caribbean for sure.
And like for me, like I don't like tremendously long flights. This is me personally. Like, I am down for an all-inclusive rate at an overwater bungalow with beautiful views and water and half the flight time.
Yes.
That sounds good to me.
Yeah, so just speaking of flight time, a lot of people either to get to St. Lucia connect through Miami, Atlanta, or Charlotte, and it's about a 3.5-hour flight from Miami.
So, wherever you're at in the States, consider flying to Miami, and then you're connecting. You have a 3.5-hour flight from there, and then you are there.
Yes. Now, two other resorts that I highly recommend there that are very, very romantic destinations and very unique resorts, and so you'll get a very unique experience. So Jade Mountain is beautiful. All of the rooms are absolutely amazing, and you have these huge pools, and you have the third wall open, and you're kind of sitting up on the mountain overlooking the Pitons, and it's absolutely beautiful.
And we just had a client stay there, sent us a video. We put it on our Instagram. You'll have to scroll down a little bit, but you'll find it. And it is unbelievable, the video footage she got.
Oh, gosh.
From her room. And it was amazing. And she sent it to us. I was like, can we share this? And of course, she's like, absolutely.
Yes. Now, rooms there are starting at $1,470 per night. That is not all inclusive, but they do have an all inclusive package that you can add on. It is quite expensive, to be completely honest with you, but that is an option. So, and Jade Mountain is also adults only.
Yeah, did they do a bachelor there too? Is that a bachelor?
Yes, they did actually film a bachelor there. I think it was
a long time ago, like 06 maybe.
No, it wasn't that long ago. I think it was like 2014 or something. Was his name Jorge, or it was the Hispanic guy? I think it was his season.
Huh.
I can't watch it. Yeah,
you watch it more than me, I think.
Well, I haven't watched it in quite some time, but that was filmed there. Yes.
The one show I do like is it The Bachelor in Paradise? What's the
one?
Oh
yeah.
Where a bunch of couples are there and.
Well, Bachelor in Paradise is where like a bunch of like they're all single, none of them worked out,
yeah,
and
that's
then
what
they
I'm
try
yeah,
to.
Yeah.
Find love out of all those people there.
And they're all like kissing and they're all kind of.
Yeah, they're all like getting with each other.
It's like a cesspool over there. And that is interesting to watch because there's a lot more drama.
Oh, yeah.
And never a dull moment in the Bachelor in Paradise.
That's very true.
I think that TV is way better than your normal Bachelor Bachelorette show. Like, we need more of the cesspool.
Oh, my gosh. I guess it's at least like entertaining.
And some people have made it. Some people have made it.
Yeah.
Out of that, haven't they? Like, there's couples.
Jade and Tanner.
They're still married?
Yeah, they have kids.
They do.
Yeah, there's a couple.
We actually watched that back in like.
And then also the girl, Ashley, she cried all the time, and I think she's married to Jared now.
That's the couple I remember. Yeah.
They've
made it?
Yeah, they're married.
Wow, Bachelor in Paradise.
Yeah, there you go.
If you ever divorce me, I'm going to have to go over there.
Okay, anyways, moving on.
I'm kidding.
Another great option, very romantic, unique resort that you can find in St. Lucia is Ladera. Very similar to Jade Mountain. All of the rooms have three walls, so you're open. You're sitting way up on the mountains in between the Pitons.
Oh, yeah.
And it's just absolutely breathtaking and a very, very unique experience. Now, I went on and priced this, and I was shocked at how low this price was, because usually this prices out not quite as expensive as Jade Mountain, but not too far behind it. But right now they have a special, and it's 40% off, and it actually truly is 40% off, because it was only $538 per night starting out.
Okay, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, and usually
for Ladera, that's ridiculous.
Yeah, I usually see it anywhere from like 900 and up per night. So that's a really good deal. So if you're looking for something very unique and romantic, a different experience, take a look at that. That's a great option. It's not all inclusive.
Yeah. And if you're an active couple, if you like to work out and you know, like, Jan and I, we go to the gym a lot. If you're like us and you like to work out together and exercise and do physically challenging activities, hike the Pitons.
I don't think you can do that right now because
really?
Yeah, the government has a lot of the land activities closed because of COVID. So that is one thing.
I bet it'll open up soon with cases kind of dropping around the country, around the world.
I mean, I hope so. They also just changed their entry requirements too. So I don't know. I hope that it does change and they allow that. But currently, they are only allowing excursions on the water.
Yeah.
Well, so a catamaran cruise around the island, that sort of thing.
Very fair. I think hiking the pitons is safer than a catamaran cruise.
I mean, I agree. It's not too many people that do it.
I mean, you're like literally on top of this mountain where no one's there. But anyways, we're not here to debate that. I am just saying, like, in normal circumstances, if that's open and you're a physically active couple and you guys like to work out together, it's challenging.
Yes.
It is not as easy as people think. They said 1 in 4 doesn't make it to the top.
Yeah, I can definitely see that.
And we were hiking it when we were there. We get to they have it broken out into, like, quarters. So you get quarter of the way there, halfway there, third of the way there, then you reach the top.
So 3/4 of the way there, yeah.
And there's, like, 3/4 of the way there. And there's, like, these little sitting areas at each little point. And you always have someone with you that's a local that climbs it all the time.
You have to have a guide. You can't do it on your own.
Yeah. And the guide's, like, we get to the 3/4 mark, he goes, this is where, you know, 1/4 of the people quit, and there's actually a guy there that quit.
Yeah, he was like, screw it, I can't do it.
Yeah, he was catching his breath, because now you have to hike all the way back down.
And the hike back down takes just as long.
Now, it does. You got to factor in a half a day to do this. Yeah. When I say hike the pitons, it's 2 hours up and probably 1.5 to 2 hours down.
And I think it took us 2.5 each way. But
yeah, and we were sweating, and it was an adventure. It was fun. And again, when I say, like, climb it, you're not, like, you don't need anything around your waist or anything. You're hiking this. Yeah. But it is, like, it's almost like a hybrid. There are little rocks you have to climb on. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. It's a treacherous hike for sure.
Yeah.
So, now moving on to one of our next most booked destinations for 2021, honeymoons and anniversaries, Jamaica.
I knew this. You made the list. I knew this was going to be on it.
Yes, Jamaica has been very, very popular, which it always is pretty popular. You can never go wrong with Jamaica. It's a beautiful island. The people are amazing, so friendly. So a couple of great options there. You know I'm not going to not mention Sandals South Coast because that is my favorite Sandals there. Actually, my favorite resort on the island, personally. I just love it. It just, as soon as you walk in, screams luxury, screams honeymoon and romantic.
It's very romantic. Yeah,
it's on a very, like, quiet, undeveloped side of Jamaica. It's absolutely beautiful.
You're kind of in the countryside. Like, there's no hustle and bustle around it. There's farmland around it, and it's like kind of this gem in the middle of nowhere almost.
Yes, yes. Now, you can get overwater bungalows there as well. They also have the overwater bar, the Latitudes, and if you wanted to get married, they have an overwater chapel there as well. So lots of options for that. Sandals South Coast starting at $481 a night for August. And also one thing to know, a lot of the rooms there have been renovated. The Dutch Village has recently been fully renovated. The Italian rooms have also been renovated. And then the French have been refreshed a little bit, not like fully renovated, but
the Dutch needed it.
Yes. They had orange walls.
Yeah.
So it needed it. But that's definitely a great option. Another one that has been very, very popular lately is Couples Negril. So you can't go wrong with Negril. It's, you know, also on the west side of Jamaica. Beautiful sunsets. This is a couples only resort, and just like in its name, and it tends to price out a little bit better than the Sandals resort. So if you're looking for something a little more affordable, definitely look at this. It's a great option. So starting at $431 per night. And if you're into nude bathing, they have that at this resort. So
nude bathing,
or not sunbathing, sorry,
nude sunbathing. I mean I'm into nude bathing. Everyone I think bathes
yeah
naked.
Sorry, I said that wrong. Sunbathing. But they have they have that here, and it's quite popular. So that's an option if you want to do something, try something a little different.
Hey, my butt cheeks are really white. I could probably use a night there.
Thank you for sharing that. The next option.
You're the one that tells me that.
We've talked a lot about this recently because we just visited Sandals Royal Caribbean and Sandals Montego Bay at the end of January. And so Sandals Royal Caribbean is amazing. They have the private island out there with the overwater bungalows. So if you're looking again for a very unique romantic experience, definitely check these out. These are awesome. You know, it comes with butler service. It's also very close close to the airport, you know, like 15-minute ride. So definitely recommend rooms starting there. $512 per night is what we found. There weren't a lot of rooms available in August, so I don't think that was the actual least expensive room type, but it was the least expensive that was available.
At that time, yeah.
Yes, and then the overwater bungalows, again, you need to book these way in advance because they sell out.
It's high demand.
Yes, but we did find three nights available in August, and it was $23.92 per night, but we could not find any, like you could not find longer than three nights stay in any of those. And one thing I do want to note, because I've gotten asked this a lot, is can you do a split stay? So like if you just want to experience the overwater bungalow, but not pay for it, you know, for the full seven nights, you can do that. So you can stay in one of those, you know, say for three nights and then move to a different room, or I would probably do that the second half of your stay, but you can do that and it would definitely help your vacation be a little more affordable that way too.
So that's a great idea. Like if you want to experience it, but you don't want to do the full seven nights at the price, because it is, I mean, it's very high, but again, it's in such demand. Again, it's like the traditional supply demand. You have that many people that want that experience, and don't get me wrong, it's incredible. I mean,
yes.
You've firsthand done it. Like it is worth every penny. But again, if you do seven nights, it's not like the most affordable thing.
No, $23.92 per night. I mean, that's a lot of money. So
yeah,
if you are looking to spend like what $8,000 on your honeymoon or $10,000, you could definitely do that or do a lower price room for three nights and then move into that for three nights, and you know, you'd be within your budget.
That's a great idea. That's a solid no before your travel tip. And yes. Honestly, if your honeymoon time frame fits where you can sneak that in, because you know they're so few and far between when they're available right now,
right,
might be worth at least looking into.
Yes.
You know what I mean? If you have the budget for it and you want to experience it, because it's a different level of, and you get a butler with that too, right?
Yes, yeah, so. You get the butler. It's awesome. And then you're also staying on a private island, which is a very unique experience.
Listen, I am all about the private islands right now.
Yes.
Royal Caribbean reignited my love for a private island off an island.
Yes.
Like, I was like, this is great. Like, we're on a private island. Like, this is awesome.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm getting the finger wheel here. Okay, we got to continue. Moving on.
Yeah, we're already at 41 minutes. So.
Oh, what? You're watching that?
Well, I don't like these.
Don't watch my
to
screen.
To stay too long. All right, so moving on. We are going to go to Mexico.
Oh, viva Las Mexico.
Which, I mean, who doesn't love Mexico? I absolutely love Mexico. It's a fun place. Now, a unique part of Mexico, if you're looking for something a little bit different and you're not necessarily a beach lover where you spend a lot of time hanging out on the beach and getting in the water, take a look at Cabo. I have been booking a lot of Cabo, and it is a beautiful destination, very different than like the east side of Mexico, Riviera Maya.
Mexico is super popular right now.
Like, it's very popular.
They're actually up in tourism from where they were last year, and it's amazing.
Well, they were, I don't think.
Around Thanksgiving.
Yeah, I don't think they are now, but they were. And it's my most booked destination right now.
And it's a tremendous value.
It is.
Your dollar goes a long way at the resorts in Mexico. Like, you just get it in the service and the food quality. They nail everything over
there. Well, depending on the resort, but yes.
Well, depending on the resort, yeah. But, like, you can find, like, for the dollar for dollar what you're going to spend, you can find some great resorts with food quality that'll blow your mind.
Yes, definitely. Now, a few that I recommend there. Of course, I have to mention Le Blanc in Cabo. I absolutely love that resort. Very chill, laid back. The spa is absolutely amazing. So if you're going to, you know, spend a lot of time in the spa, please look at Le Blanc Cabo. You get the hydrotherapy sessions included with your stay
adults
every day.
Adults only too? Adults only?
Yep, it's adults only and all inclusive. And then you do have, you know, the butler service, which is kind of like a personal concierge. It's different than like Sandals butlers. But definitely take a look at that. $572 per night is what it's starting at in August. Now, August and September are going to be the absolute hottest months of the year to go there. So just keep that in mind. You might want to look at a little bit different time, but
or
it's definitely a great option.
In the pool.
Or you'll be spending a lot of time in the pool.
Yeah, which isn't a bad thing.
Yes. Now, a few other options if you're looking for something a little different and not all-inclusive, the Cape.
Oh,
this is one
gosh.
Of my favorite.
I knew you were going to include this one.
Yes, this is one of my favorite non-all-inclusive resorts. It's a smaller property, has a great, fun, hip vibe to it. Infinity pool overlooking the ocean, and you can see the arch in the background. Absolutely beautiful. I don't know that I would stay here for a full week, but I think it's great for like shorter stays, like 3 to 5 nights. I think it's perfect for that. And rooms there are starting at $459 per night.
And they have great restaurants on property.
Yes, great restaurants. And then you're also like 10 minutes away from the marina, the Cabo San Lucas Marina.
Yeah.
So you can go and enjoy a lot of great restaurants right there. And there's actually a really great restaurant right next door. I can't think of the name of it right now, but it overlooks the...
Oh, I know what you're talking about. Yeah, yeah. It's up on the hillside.
Yeah, it's up on the hillside and overlooks the arch too. And that one gets booked up in advance too, because it's amazing to watch the sunsets from there.
You can pretty much walk over there.
Yeah, you can walk there from the Cape. Yeah. Then another option, this one is not adults only, but it is a beautiful resort. I would definitely recommend it. One and Only Palmilla.
Mm.
You're like, I have not heard of this one.
Mm. It's a new one, yeah.
Yes, but they actually have a lot of these resorts kind of all over the world. Like they have one in the Maldives. And these are really, really nice, super high-end luxury resorts. Focus on wellness and the spa. Beautiful property. And that's starting at $905 a night. And that has also been pretty popular for 2021 as well.
Is that Numero Uno?
No.
Are we at drumroll, Numero Uno?
Yeah, like I said, people are going to be like, oh, I wasn't expecting that.
Yeah, you might be throwing a curve a lot. I haven't seen the full list. So
yes. So my absolute number one most booked destination for honeymoons and anniversary trips for 2021 is Cancun/Riviera Maya.
Really?
Yes.
Well, for 2021, I can definitely see that. And, you know, I'm not that surprised, actually.
No, I'm not surprised.
I'm not that surprised.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's very, very affordable, number one. Two, you don't have to have the COVID test to enter, but I would suggest now, since they are requiring it in order to come back home to the States, I would test before you go just to be on the safe side. I know they're not pleasant, but I would definitely recommend it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now, yes, a couple of our top resorts booked there for honeymoons and destination weddings. If you've been a longtime listener of the show, you probably know two of the ones that I'm going to say. So Le Blanc, you know, we stayed there in November.
Love
absolutely amazing. Similar to the one in Cabo, except it's on a swimmable beach. It's right in the hotel zone. Great area. And it's also in a fun part, you know, being in the hotel zone. There's a lot of things to do in that area. When we were there, there were a lot of shops and stuff closed down. But usually, it's a pretty hopping part of Cancun.
And it's only going to get better from now. Like, I don't see us going backwards anytime soon. Like, we are just going to keep... That area will continue to open up and open up and open up. And
yes.
Like, honestly, when we were there, we never even left the resort anyway. So
it's
so nice to not, I mean, you don't have to.
And it's just
so,
yeah. And it, just like the one in Cabo, very just chill and laid back. And I feel like that's what a lot of honeymoon couples and anniversary couples are looking for. You just want to like get away, relax, have fun, just the two of you.
Yeah. And like we took into consideration when you put this together and when we were like kind of building this out, you know, you got to look at like, so we've been to so many resorts where they're playing, you go to the pool, they're playing top 40 music and it's getting kind of rowdy, you know, come like 2 o'clock in the afternoon. That's not for us, at least, like, honey, like, it's not like romantic. So we kind of took into consideration the vibes. You know?
Oh, yes.
And if that's your vibe, though, if you like that, then sure, absolutely.
Yes.
You should go to, there's tons of great options for that. We just kind of took consideration maybe like having a little more chill vibe, a little more intimacy.
Yes.
You know, but again, a honeymoon is going to be very individual to the person that you are.
Oh, yes. Yeah. These are just, again, the ones that I have been booking the most for 2021.
Yeah.
So another one, Unico 2087. Of course, I'm going to mention that one. I love that. So it's about 75 minutes or so from the hotel zone. An absolutely beautiful resort. I love this property. If you're looking for something not right in the hotel zone of Cancun and something different, this is definitely a great option. One of the best food resorts that we have been to. I would probably give LeBlanc a slight edge.
Yeah,
on
LeBlanc's
that.
Got the edge, yes, but it's, not, it's not by much.
No, not by much. But Unico has really great options for restaurants, and I just absolutely loved that resort, and the service was amazing.
Yeah.
Pretty laid back, chill vibe. I don't think you can go wrong with that.
And it's in a much different area than the hotel zone. Like, you are more remote.
Yeah.
You're out there.
You're about 30 minutes from Tulum. So.
And you can golf at the Hard Rock. Now, you have to pay for it, but it's a sister property.
Well, you have to just pay the 25% fee.
You pay the 25% fee, and it's all you can drink and eat at the golf course as well.
Yes. So when the cargo, George loves bringing that up.
I love bringing that up. When the cargo comes around, you get whatever you want. There's no, like, and that's cool. So, again, if there's a couple out there that are having their anniversary and they're golfers, know before you go travel tip, go to Unico. Go hit up the Hard Rock.
Yes, and one other great thing about Unico is the 25% fee. So they have the Limitless All-Inclusive is what it's called. And basically they have all of their spa treatments. You'll only pay a 25% fee for that. And then they have certain or a select number of excursions that you can also book, and you only pay a 25% service fee, like swimming with the dolphins is one. I think there's a cenote experience, it's another. So it's definitely, it's a really affordable, it ends up being a very affordable honeymoon, you know, once you add in, you know, the massages and excursions and things like that.
And the cave experience was really cool, what we did.
Oh, yes. Now, that was not a part of the Limitless All-Inclusive. That was extra.
No, but it was an excursion you could do.
Yes, and Rio Secreto. Highly recommend it.
Yeah, and it was like we had our own tour guide, too. It was a private tour guide, which was great.
Yes.
He was awesome, very knowledgeable. And again, it's kind of like an adventure. And like, I wouldn't classify us as like overly adventurous, but if you have like, if you want to do something different on your anniversary, which I recommend you do, like do something that you might not do otherwise, that's a good option for you if you're not a golfer.
Yes, definitely agree. Now, last but not least, if you are looking at, because obviously we kind of have a little bit of a common theme in some of these, is an overwater bungalow. They do have them in Mexico, and they are pretty much the most affordable ones that you can find. And like on this side of the world, and that are all-inclusive. Belize has a few, but that's completely different. So Palafito's Overwater Bungalows at El Dorado Maroma Resort, which Maroma Beach is one of the top beaches in Mexico. And you can get into an overwater bungalow there for $1,700 per night.
Whoa.
Yes.
That's a deal.
That is a deal. And that's all-inclusive.
We told you, Mexico's got the best deals.
Yes. So I found that to be very popular as well.
I would say, because like, okay, if you're going purely...
And it's adults only.
Adults only, all-inclusive, and and you're getting your best price overwater bungalow. If you want to go all in for 7 nights in an overwater bungalow, that's your ticket.
Yes, I mean, to do it the most affordable way.
To do it the most affordably, of course, yeah.
Yes, definitely.
And awesome.
They do stay booked up fairly well in advance, but, I mean, not as... I find them easier to get than like the sandals options. So
perfect.
But I think that's a list. I didn't know that was quite the long list, but those are our most booked romantic vacations for 2021.
Yeah, and if you want more information, guys, again, if you listen to this, you have a specific question or you're planning a trip or a free service, you can hit us up. We'll plan the whole thing. We're a zero fee travel agency. And request a quote, penyaktravel.com. It goes right to Janet.
Yes.
Not to me, right to Janet. And she can help get you everything you need, custom to what you want and need, and she'll tailor it for you. And again, link is in the show notes, or it's penyaktravel.com. Request a quote right there. And we would love, that's the best way to support the show. Now it's time for
question of the day.
Question of the day.
All right, what is it?
I still need to get a jingle.
Yeah.
For the question
okay,
of the day.
Okay. This podcast has been going on a long time.
I got a good one here. We're still drinking wine here. I'm fun. Okay. I want to hear what you, this is a good one. What is important but not urgent on your to-do list right now?
Important but not urgent?
What is important but not urgent on your to-do list right now? I already know what mine is.
If
you want me to change the question, I can throw something else.
I was going to say, I don't know. I don't really have, I mean, outside of work stuff, I don't really have anything on my to-do list.
You don't have a single thing on your to-do list outside of work?
I mean, change the lights in the kitchen.
Dang, that was going to be mine.
I knew you were going to
say
that.
Okay, we're doing a new question.
Okay, then I can take, I bought a new rug. There you go.
Yeah, that's up there. Okay, here we go. What's something you would really hate to lose?
Something I would really hate to lose.
Besides me, obviously. I mean, come on. Who would want to lose me?
I guess my phone.
Phone's big.
Yeah, that's very important.
Phone's big. I'm going to say phone with today's technology, you can recover it pretty easily. You know, you get to do the recovery and you can like lock it out and like freeze it and wipe it remotely. I think still losing your wallet is the worst because then you have to get a new ID. You got to get new credit cards. And you know, if you get new credit cards, you get a new credit card number and everything that you get auto pay out of your credit card. My God, you got to go in there and reset all of that crap.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, that would be a pain.
The worst.
And keys.
Keys are real bad, too.
That would be really bad, too.
When are keys going to become phones? If your phones are going to take over keys.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like, we'll be telling our grandkids, we had the keys. We had to stick this metal thing in the door. Stop. And if you lost the key, you couldn't get in the door anymore. And they're going to be like, geez, Grandpa, you're old. Like, we have, like there's, like, just Bluetooth connection and just, like, knows who you are or fingerprints or something.
Okay.
We're like, remember those keys, honey? Remember we would jingle those keys?
Okay, let's stop.
Remember they came up with those sound makers?
All right, guys, so I think that is a show. So, again, if you want any more information on anything you've heard today, please feel free to reach out. You can slide into our DMs, go to our website, penyaktravel.com, hit request a quote, comes directly to me, or just give me a call, 1-800-674-3278. I'm in the office every day, Monday through Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m.
You just gave me the hard shut-up cutoff there. It's like, not even.
Well, you're making grandpa imitations. It's time to go.
We love our grandparents.
Yes.
Okay. Love you guys.
Thanks for listening.